Hi there, I'm Luke, your friendly language and linguistics enthusiast, and this is Go Natural English. Have you ever heard people talk about the Canadian accent, maybe in movies and TV shows, and wonder exactly what it is? Well, you've come to the right place, because as someone who has lived in both countries, as well as being a dual citizen of both the US and Canada, I am here to walk you through some of the differences that I've noticed having lived and spoken to lots of people from both countries. Whether you've just moved to Canada and want to understand a bit more about the dialect and culture, or if you, like me, just enjoy guessing people's nationalities based on their accent, then you have come to the right place and let's get into it. As always, if you like these English tips, be sure to give this video a thumbs up. This helps us keep our channel and community going. First of all, did you know that there is not just one Canadian accent? Just like for Americans, you wouldn't say that there is only one American accent when comparing someone from New York City to someone from Texas. The same applies for Canadian English as well. You have to remember that Canada is a huge country. In fact, it's the second largest country by landmass in the world. So it's not entirely surprising that there is some variation in the Canadian English accent. However, I will say, though, that it's not quite as diverse and varied as you would see in other countries, like in Great Britain. There's some regional variation, but for the most part, there is a definite agreed-upon standard Canadian English. And that's going to be the one that I'm going to talk to you about today. One final point before we get started, and that is that how strong someone's accent is can vary more than just based on geography. It can vary based on how old someone is versus young, as well as whether someone grew up in maybe a more urban environment like Toronto or Vancouver compared to a more rural type of environment. You're more likely to find stronger accents, I find, in the older generation, as well as in the more rural locations when it comes to the Canadian accent. Whereas the younger, more urban types tend to have a slightly milder accent. With all of this in mind, let's dive in. Starting off with number one, I would say this is the most well-known and talked about difference between American and Canadian pronunciation, and that is the infamous oot and a boot. Let's get this out of the way, and I feel comfortable saying this as both an American and a Canadian. We do not say oot and a boot. Americans may think they hear this, but this is really exaggerated compared to the truth. However, it is true that Canadians do say it differently than Americans. So you might be asking yourself, how do they say it? While Americans, as you probably know, are more likely to say out and about, Canadians are more likely to say out and about. Do you hear the difference between the two, but not quite sure how it's different? Stay tuned and I'll tell you how. This is a process called Canadian raising. It's called this because in order to make this vowel, Canadians say it a little bit higher in the mouth than Americans say it, with Americans using a slightly lower pronunciation with the jaw and tongue. Look at this diagram. Americans tend to start with the ah vowel and move up to the vowel to make ow, ow, out. Canadians start a little bit higher. So rather than starting from ah, they tend to start from So they'll say out, out, out. Do you hear and see the difference in how I make those sounds? There's a bit more to Canadian raising than just words like out and about. So if you want me to talk more about them in a future video, be sure to let me know in the comments down below. For number two, we have the pronunciation of some words that start with pro. In fact, I don't know if you caught it, but I happened to say one of these words in point number one. Did you hear it? I said process, which is quite different than how most Americans would say this word. Here's the difference. In certain words that start with pro, Canadians tend to say these words with a true O vowel. So they tend to say process, project, and progress. Whereas Americans are more likely to pronounce these words with an ah vowel. So they would tend to say process, project, and progress. Isn't it interesting how these small differences emerge between the two dialects? I will say though that like most of the things on this list, not every Canadian does this, but if you do happen to hear someone with a North American accent who says process, project, or progress, chances are you're talking to a Canadian. All right, moving on to number three, and that is when you see words that have O followed by an R. In most American dialects, if you see a word with OR in the middle of the word, you tend to pronounce the O as more of an ah vowel. So take, for example, some words that you may already know. Words like sorry, borrow, and tomorrow. You'll notice that they aren't really pronounced like an O, but really more like an ah. In Canadian dialects, you'll often hear people often pronounce these words with more of an O sound. So rather than saying borrow, you'll hear Canadians say borrow. Rather than saying sorry, you'll hear Canadians often say sorry. And rather than tomorrow, you'll hear Canadians often say tomorrow. Quite an interesting difference, don't you think? Next up with number four, differences between Americans and Canadians' pronunciation. Did you know that many Americans and Canadians say these words differently? In many American dialects, they would say these words with an ah vowel, like you would hear in words like call and father. Whereas in many Canadian dialects, they would say these words with an ah vowel, such as in words like cat and sad. As a result, words that Americans would say as pasta and salsa would be pronounced by many Canadians as pasta and salsa. I want to make the point that this is not across the board. This is not every word that you see that's spelled with an A is pronounced like ah when Americans say it, and every word that's spelled with an A is pronounced as ah when Canadians say it. It's more in a specific set of words, and it's often words that are adopted from other languages. So for example, pasta or pasta comes from Italian, and salsa or salsa comes from Spanish. So there's not a ton of these words that make this distinction, but I still find it interesting to note and listen to it whenever I'm in Canada or the US, hearing the difference between the two pronunciations. All right, last but not least, we have one that we come across with older generations, but I still think it's useful to know these because you might hear it on the news or TV. And I also often get questions from students of mine who moved to Canada and maybe read about it in a book or learned about it from a teacher that Canadians say these words this way. And they want to know if it's still really truly the case. And that is the pronunciation of the highlighted letters in these words. Traditionally, these words were said differently based on whether you are American or Canadian, where it used to be that Americans would say the highlighted letters with more of an oo sound, whereas traditionally, Canadians would say these vowels with more of a u sound. So what that means is that Americans would say news, student, and Tuesday, whereas some Canadians would often say news, student, Tuesday. I often heard these pronunciations from my grandparents, but I never really quite knew why a lot of people my age didn't really say them this way. And that's because it is more of a generational difference. You'll find that older Canadians tend to say it with these pronunciations, whereas you'll find younger Canadians tend to say it a bit more like how Americans say it, with an oo pronunciation. Not a huge difference, but kind of a fun thing to know about and understand. All right, that is it for this video. I hope you learned something new, and please leave a comment down below to let us know what you think. I love getting into nitty-gritty topics like this, so if there are any other subjects that you're interested in as they relate to American English, then please let me know and I will be happy to make a video about it in the future. If you haven't already, be sure to comment, like, and subscribe for more content like this. And if you'd like to continue learning, click here for another video. See you soon. Bye.